हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू आर एम पी एस स्कूल एंड वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द पार्ट नंबर 3 ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन प्लांट. सो टूडेज टॉपिक इज ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ फूड एंड अदर सब्सटेंसेस. एज यू नो दैट प्लांट मेक देयर फूड विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम रॉ मटेरियल. And the food is mainly made or formed in the leaves. The form of the food that is formed in the leaves is the glucose. So the food that is formed in the leaves by the process of photosynthesis is need to be transported to the different part of the plant. Why it is needed so? Because if it is get accumulated over here, no more photosynthesis will occur. So there should be the translocation of food. Food should be translocated from leaves to the different part of the plant where is its requirement. So let's study. We know that during the process of photosynthesis, glucose is produced by the green leaves. I think you understood this part. Next, the question arises over here, why it is necessary to transport the glucose from the leaves? I have already given the answer of this question. It is known to us that glucose is necessary for the production of energy. So glucose is the basic source of energy. And this glucose is formed in the leaves. While energy is required by the each and every cell of the plant. So this glucose should be transported to each and every living cells so that the living cell can utilize the glucose in the process of respiration to produce energy. That is written over here. It is known to us that glucose is the production necessary for the production of energy. Thus the glucose is necessary to transport to the different part of the plant. And this transport of soluble product of photosynthesis is called translocation of food. So here one more question arises. What do you mean by translocation of food? So translocation of food is nothing but the transport of the soluble substances from the leaves to the different part of the plant, mainly glucose, amino acid and certain more substances. I think you understood. Now another question arises over here. Which tissue help in translocation of food? Just answer me. I think you know all this. All of you know the answer of this question. Yes, translocation of food take place with the help of phloem. As you know, xylem and phloem together called vascular bundle. And xylem help in the transport of water and mineral. While the phloem helps in the transportation of food materials. Yeah. So transportation of food is also called translocation of food. Now one more question is arising over here. What are the substances that is translocated by phloem? Although we know the answer of this question, translocation, the basic substances that or product that is translocated by the process is glucose, amino acid and some other products. So there are three basic substances there that are translocated with the help of phloem, mainly glucose, amino acid and certain other substances that is particular for a particular kind of plant. Next, where are the food and other substances transported? I have already given the answer of this question. I told you that the plant prepared the food in the leaves. And if it is not transported to the different part of the leaf, from the different part of the plant, the food will be accumulated over here. and it is so highly concentrated that it can't be able to do the photosynthesis during the day further. So in course of photosynthesis, they also help or translocate all the food. Although very little amount of food material, that is glucose, is stored in form of starch. Very important question I am telling over here. Starch. What is starch? Starch is the insoluble form of the glucose. While, listen to me carefully, once again I am repeating it. While the plant doing the photosynthesis, they make a lots of glucose. But this glucose is soluble in water. So it will increase the concentration of this cell. So the plant immediately convert this glucose into starch, and starch is insoluble form, and starch is the storage. Starch can be stored for several time. While they convert the glucose into starch, they get enough place to do the photosynthesis. During evening or at night, when there is no photosynthesis take place, at that time starch is again converted into glucose, and this glucose is transported to the different part of the leaf plant with the help of phloem. I think you understood. So what happened during the day? During the day photosynthesis happens, glucose forms, and this glucose converted into starch, and the starch remain in the leaves. But at night, when photosynthesis doesn't take place, what happens? This starch again convert into glucose, that is in soluble form, and this soluble glucose is transported to the different part of the plant where it is required or get stored, isn't it? So let's study the answer of the question. Where are the food and other substance transported? These substances are especially delivered to the storage organ, like root, seed, or the growing organs. So the food are either stored or utilized. If the food is stored, the food will be stored in the root and seeds, and it is utilized in the growing organ for growth and development. For storage, it goes to the root, fruit, and seed, and at the immediate utilization, they go to the growing organ or growing tips, because the growing tips require a lots of glucose for growth and development. I think you understood this topic. Now we have a next and very important question. Name the kind of phloem which help in translocation of different kinds of nutrients. So we have studied that there are different kinds of nutrient that is transported by the phloem. So which kind of phloem? We have already studied in our class 9 that phloem, there are 4 kinds of phloem. Which one? Sieve tube, companion cells, and phloem parenchyma, and phloem fiber. So among all these 4, phloem fiber is dead, but 3 are living, that is sieve tube, companion cells, and phloem parenchyma. Phloem parenchyma help in the storage. Phloem parenchyma help in the storage of the food. So now we left with only 2. What are it? It is, just a minute, it is sieve tube and companion cells. So the kind of phloem that help in translocation of food is mainly sieve tube and companion cells. And in which direction the transport of food take place? Transport of food take place both in upward and downward direction. because if it is leaf, then it will be the growing tip. So the food will go to the growing tip, and food can also go to the root. So in this way of transport, you can say bidirectional. Bidirectional means bi means two, directional movement of food or glucose take place over here. I think you understood. But in case of xylem, only one directional water is transport in only one direction, from root to the leaves. But in case of phloem, food is translocated in the both direction, in upward as well as downward direction. I think you understood. Next, how the transportation of by xylem differ from phloem, or how translocation of food material take place by phloem? It is one of the most important question. Unlike transport in xylem, which can be largely explained by physical forces, in xylem the transport system, the transport of substances takes place by diffusion, by active transport, by transpiration pool, and many more physical processes are involved over here. But in case of translocation, active transport take place while by utilizing energy, means translocation of food take place by utilizing energy. And how is the energy utilized? Just we are going to learn about this. Material like sucrose is transported to the phloem tissue using energy from ATP. Energy formed, it is not from, it should be formed. ATP. Okay. Just a minute. See the figure I am showing over here. It is the cell of the leaf. Here sucrose means sugar glucose. Sucrose has been made. Now the sucrose is transported to the companion cells. This is the companion cells. One of the kind of phloem. As the companion cell has the highly concentration due to the accumulation of sucrose, the water from xylem is drawn out. Because you know that water moves toward the higher concentration. As in osmosis, I already told you, during the course of osmosis, what happened? Water moved, the pure solvent moved from their higher concentration to lower concentration. So sugar attracts water. So the water from xylem move into the companion cell, and it become dissolved. While it dissolves, at the same time the phloem take the glucose and it start transport in the both direction. Once again, may I repeat it to make you understand? Listen carefully, you'll understand what happens during the daytime. When the leaves make the glucose, this glucose is transported by expenditure of energy, that is in form of ATP. Actually, energy is expended by companion cells to draw the glucose from leaves to the companion cell. So when the food is transported from leaves to the companion cell, energy is utilized, and when the companion cell get the glucose, it become highly concentrated. And when it become highly concentrated, water from the xylem move toward the companion cell and make it dissolve. And when it get dissolved, it automatically move toward the phloem sieve tube, and this is the sieve tube. And the sieve tube move the translocate the food up and down on the both direction where it is utilized or restored. So you can see in the figure, the food is coming and again return back to the companion cell, and the companion cell help it to store in the storage organ. This is called sink. Sink means where the food is get stored, either it be the leaf, stem or root. Understood? So let's study it in detail. Material like sucrose is transformed into phloem tissue by energy. First of all, let us study from earlier. Unlike transport in xylem, which can be largely explained by physical forces, translocation of food by phloem is achieved by utilizing energy. Means energy is utilized to transport the food material, because food material are highly concentrated and it cannot be transported one cell to another cell without the expenditure of energy. So energy is expended to draw the food material from one cell to another cell. I think understand. Next, another step. Material like sucrose. Sucrose means it is also a kind of glucose. Sucrose, fructose, maltose is all the glucose. Is transferred into the phloem tissue by utilizing energy, that is in form of ATP. This energy has more osmotic pressure. It increases the osmotic pressure because it is highly concentrated. So it increases the osmotic pressure, and due to that, water from the xylem move into the companion cell, that is the kind of phloem. So it increases the osmotic pressure of the tissue, causing water to move into it. When water move into it, it get dissolved, and this pressure move the material into the phloem tissue, which have less pressure. So the dissolved material move into the sieve tube, and this allow the phloem to move material according to the plant's need. Where it is required, it moves ups and downs in the both direction. And for example, during the spring there is a lots of supply of water and mineral is there. At that time the plant make their food very efficiently, means more food is formed in the leaves, and this formed food is stored in either the root or in stem and transported to the bud, which need the energy. Means bud means the growing tips where it is required. I think understood. Remember to draw this, because it will always help you to understand the whole phenomenon. I think you understood the topic. If you have any kind of query, you can ping me in WhatsApp and you can also call me. Hope for your better learning. Make the notes and send it to me in the WhatsApp. Thank you very much. Bye bye.